Butting back in 1981 with Kirby Best out of Toronto.
All right, we have a slight delay, a little bit of garbage on the track here at Canada Olympic Park, but a good shot of how the 27,000 plus here are enjoying this show put on by the two-man Bobs. Here's Dave Lutie and Kevin Tyler.
David also has the unofficial start time here in the Canada Olympic Park.
Good, and up.
There it is, 0.03 slower than the fastest sled so far this heat. So that's a competitive start, and he drives the upper part of this course extremely well. Listen to the crowd. He's done a beautiful job in the upper half. He's still well within contention on the leading sleds, and there's been one or two go down very swiftly considering the condition of the track. Reasonable time into Kreisel.
David has had problems with consistency here in Calgary. However, he seems to be overcoming that now, and tomorrow he has a very good seating.
Let's remember Greg Hadelung is third in Canada 1 after the first heat. Here's Dave Lutie trying to improve his finish. And he has a sixth place standing after the
since 1980
heats, and of course the leader is still to come.
That's not so bad. That's not so bad. That'll move him up considerably. The run's getting slower, and a 59.08 was much closer than what he had the first time. I don't think you're going to see much better than a 50, high 58 in today's run, except for the early sleds.
All right, that's it for now from the bobsled. Let's go back to Dan Matheson.
At the medals, he's going to retire after this.
There it is, a 5:56 start. Not really in contention from the start. A quarter of a second off the pace means more than a half a second in loss of momentum at the start. But he does drive well. He had a not too great first run, 21st place after the first, so this has got to be disappointing to him. But he does drive well on the way down. He'll pick up a few places. I think he's really trying to find a little extra time. He came very high in one of those earlier corners, trying to loop out of it and get a bit of a G-drop.
Again, the shades on the Chrysler corners with a warm Calgary sun this afternoon can melt away at that ice, although this is an excellent refrigerated course.
And here we come. Down the final little curves, and I'm afraid he's out of contention.
Hans Hildebrand, Switzerland, won seventh at this point in the second heat. He went down 17th, but the leaders are mostly still to come.
This refrigerated course can put 1,250 tons of ice in a 24-hour period on this course, and we noticed last year during the World Cup that it held up in temperatures of 20 degrees Celsius.
Very balmy in Calgary today. Temperatures 12 degrees Celsius at our location at Canada Olympic Park, and the track is withstanding. Of course, now we've had some 55 sleds, and that really can tear up the course. To the top now, here's the United States two sled of Matthew Roy and James Herbereich.
Matt is driving USA 2. He's here in place of Randy Will. Randy Will had better start times here, better finish times all week, but Matt has been consistent. He's the World Cup winner from last year.
Willie Gault will not take part in the two-man.
But he's going to have to drive very well with a third of a second off the pace to start. And his first run, of course, wasn't exactly scintillating. So maybe they made the wrong choice.
Twenty-ninth for Matt Roy after the first run.
He seems to be driving well, a little high off that corner for the speed that he was going. Now he's coming into the crucial corner before Kreisel, and he came off a little early. He tried to cut ice on that. He didn't let it go, and he hit on the Kreisel straight, and he doesn't have the speed coming around. So he's losing time steadily all the way down the track.
Through the labyrinth into the finish corner for Matt Roy of the United States. Matt Roy stands 10th in the second run, but the leader's still to come, and CTV's coverage of the 1988 Calgary Winter Olympics will continue right after this. The 27,000 plus people out here, as they are about to be given a royal treat, because coming up next, as now we watch the end of New Zealand 2, the royalty of the sport of bobsled, and certainly another fellow getting a lot of publicity because of his endeavors in the world of sport, and we are about to see Prince Albert of Monaco make his second run.
And because it's the champagne of thrills, it's always been the sport of kings. So it's nice to have at least one member of a royal family around.
And here is Prince Albert of Monaco. His brakeman is Gilbert Bessie. They were 17th after the first run, which was very respectable.
Prince Albert is paying his dues in the sport here. He went to the FIBT Bob School last year. He competed there. He competed in St. Moritz. He is also the youngest member of the IOC.
He's used to snow and ice. He's a good skier, he's a good athlete, but he's not very big. And so half a second off the pace at the start is a big deficit to overcome. But he seems to be getting onto this course. And because he rides a horse as well, which means that he knows how to collect the reins, which is not dissimilar, in time, he could become a good bobber, particularly in the foreman. Cut off that corner a little bit. Here he is in the long prizel straight. You can see that big 270-degree turn. Out of sight under the screens, and he'll come around.
We'll pick him up underneath the bridge by the chrysal.
And here he is in the lower labyrinths. He's very safe now. He's certainly gone beyond that stage in sledding, and he's now in the middle of the pack. Bit by bit, he'll get better and better.
Prince Albert of Monaco in Monaco 1. To the finish line in a time of
mine saying I'm going to do it. I'm going to do my
of a second. There's a combined time under two that is very decent. He stands in 11th place. But coming up in the next couple of sleds now, we have the leader of the pack. Prince Albert was the first man down in the first run. He was the 22nd man down in run number two.
One of the major factors in bobsledding is pushing the sled at the start. A two-man sled with crew weighs 885 pounds, 390 kilos. That's one hell of a challenge for everybody.
Back to the top now. This is Austria 1. Ingo Applett and Harold Winkler.
Off his back.
Surprisingly in second place after the first run, and they are very close to the leader, Wolfgang Hoppe of East Germany. Remember, Greg Haydenluck in third place.
And that's slower than his last start time. He had a 5:38 last time, which wasn't that competitive, but he obviously has the track down very well, and he drives the upper straights and corners beautifully. And so he's, I would say, if not the best, one of the very best drivers on this course at this moment in two-man.
57.22 was his first time. The track is much slower now, though.
He's three-quarters of a second off the pace for first.
Thing to keep in mind is that his placing in this heat, although it may be lower, his overall placing will move up because of his great first run.
Absolutely. And he seems to be doing a reasonable job. I don't think quite so well as last time.
Ingo has yet to win a World Cup or a major event like a World Championships or an Olympics. This is as close as he's been, and I think he can feel it.
Second place after the first heat, Ingo Applett now. Fourth place. Fourth place, he has dropped down a couple of positions. And his time of 157.05, very respectable, but the equalization of where you start is beginning to show.
You know, with that much of a deficit over his first run, it gives a look to all of us that there's
really
changes in the second heat. And we can only hope that coming up shortly, of course, within a few sleds, will be Greg Haydenluck, that he won't be too badly affected by it. If he can get through this round with his starting order tomorrow, he's in great shape.
Now from West Germany, Michael Speer and Rolf Müller, fifth after the first run.
Michael was 16th in the World Cup Series last year in the combined. He has a challenge in front of him. He also suffered a large accident back in Trevinia a year ago, left him in a coma for 17 days.
That's a little slower than his first start time, but at least we can expect that in spite of that coma you were talking about, that he won't be worried about speed. These sliders all get used to the speed. It's a full-out kind of a race. It's a sport of precision, and when you get into these kind of leagues in the World Championship Olympic competition, you know how to drive a sled safely. It's a question of precision. And this is what he's got to go for. He seems to be cutting off those corners a little bit hard. He should leave it on a little longer. It's very difficult to tell the difference if you're not used to the sport, but it's there. And just watch those sleds and see how long they stay on the corners and how smoothly they come off.
Into the home stretch now for Michael Speer of West Germany. Fifth after the first run. Dropped down a bit to seventh. In fact, kind of a slow run for Speer.
He didn't have a good run at all, Jeff. He was definitely cutting off these corners, a bit nervous, and that's not what they say about speeds and accidents. It's about doing well.
All right, now let's just review. Kipurs from the Soviet Union is the leader right now in heat two, followed by Lehmann and Vieter. Lehmann, the East German two-sled, Vieter, the Swiss two-sled, and then it's Ingo Appelt in fourth position. He was in second place after the first run. Still to come, and very shortly, the first place man after the first run, Wolfgang Hoppe, and Greg Haydenluck, who was in third after first place. We can already see that Appelt
for the United States
some placings. Now from Chinese Taipei, Quangbing Sun and Chin San Chen.
Quang Ming also races in the luge events here, and he was also in the luge in Sarajevo. So two disciplines, two Olympic Games.
There's a great perspective of the start. Coming up to the first 50 meter timing point. Drivers just popped in. Brakeman will swing in from behind, collapse the bars, and away they go. 34 100s, it wasn't a great start, but they're a respectable team, and Taipei is doing very well out here. Now you can see them coming towards that first big curve to the left.
Corner four, speeds now accelerating over 85 kilometers an hour. That corner has a G-force of 3.
Taipei is using a standard sled with a standard cowling, the cowling being the fiberglass shell covering the frame on the bottom. Sleds are either Podars or Siorpes, coming from Cortina, Italy. Or if you don't choose that, you can buy an East German sled, but I don't think they'll sell you one.
They certainly won't sell you one in great shape. It may be an old clapped out ball, but maybe get you down better than some of the old standard ones.
All right, Quang Ming Sun, Taipei 2 sled. Time. You can see his placing, and that's over five seconds past the leader. But now it's time to turn our attention, and certainly this run could be the critical run of the
Motown.
This is where he has to maintain his positioning.
This is an opportunity not only for him to solidify his position, but to move up. And very shortly.
The sled is Greg Haydenluck, Canada 1.
Ski 12.
Lloyd Guss, third place after the first run.